Hola, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Soy Paula de Speak Spanish with Paula. If you're new here, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe and to hit the notification bell. Today we're going to discuss what's the difference between bien and bueno. When to use bien and bueno in Spanish. The equivalent in English are well and good. One is an adverb and the other one is an adjective. And I know you're thinking, Paula, I don't care how they are called, just tell me when to use them. But you gotta know at least the basics, so here we go. An adverb is used to describe how an action is executed, to add characteristics to a verb. For example, she speaks Spanish well. What's the verb? Speak. How she speaks Spanish? Well, we're asking how the action of speaking is executed by her. Well, in Spanish would be ella habla español bien. ¿Cómo habla ella español? Bien, we're describing cómo ella habla español. Ella habla bien. So one more time, the verb is hablar. How she speaks, cómo ella habla. Ella habla bien. You gotta use an adverb to describe how the action is executed. Now, an adjective describes a noun, a thing, an object, an idea, an entity, all right? So, for example, her Spanish is good. Her Spanish is good. We're describing how is her Spanish. Spanish is not a verb. We don't say yo Spanish, tú Spanish, right? It's a noun. And we are answering the question, how her Spanish is. ¿Cómo es su español? ¿Cómo es su español? Su español es bueno. El español de ella es bueno. So the adverb bien answers how an action is executed. And the adjective bueno answers how is a thing. I hope you're following me. Now, bueno, it's not the only one. We also have buena, buenos, buenas. Why? Because a noun, a thing, an object, get genders in Spanish. So bueno is for singular masculine, buenos, plural masculine, buena for feminine singular, and buenas for feminine plural. And what about buen? When it's also used for singular masculine. And how are they different? We're gonna see it in a bit. Let's practice a little bit first. If I tell you, I'm going to watch a good movie, how would you say it? Think about it. Voy a ver una película buena. Why buena? Because movie, película, is feminine. And I'm going to watch only one movie. So, singular, feminine, buena. Voy a ver una película buena. What about my mom cooks well? My mom cooks well. How do you say it? Mi mamá cocina bien. Mi mamá cocina bien. Why? Because we are describing how my mom cooks, the action of cooking. My mom cooks well. Mi mamá cocina bien. But I could also say, la comida de mi mamá es buena. Why? Because in this case, I'm not talking about how she cooks, but how is her food? We're talking about the food, la comida. And it's singular and it's feminine, so la comida de mi mamá es buena. What about vegetables are good? How do you say it? Los vegetales son buenos. We're describing los vegetales. ¿Cómo son los vegetales? Los vegetales son buenos. Masculine, plural, buenos. Another example. Ella es una profesora buena. She's a good teacher. Ella es una profesora buena. Why am I using buena? Because I'm describing How is she as a teacher? ¿Cómo es ella como profesora? Buena. Now, if I say, ella enseña bien, I'm describing how she teaches. I'm describing the action of teaching. I'm describing the verb. So I say, ella enseña bien, with an adverb. Ellos son profesores buenos. Ellos enseñan bien. ¿Sí? Now, the general rule of adjective in Spanish is using them after the noun. Tengo un carro pequeño. La comida fría no me gusta. Ella es una hermana buena. Él es un hermano bueno. Ellos son unos padres buenos. But when it comes to bueno, buena, buenos, or buenas, you could use them before the noun. And in fact, it's a little bit more natural to use it that way. So you could say, ella es una buena hermana. Ellos son unos buenos padres. Él es una buena persona. Be careful here. We are talking about how is he as a person. And because person, persona, is feminine, we gotta use buena. And una, because we're talking about he, it's only one. Él es una buena persona. But I can't say, él es un bueno hombre. Don't say that. When you are in front of a singular masculine noun and you want to use the adjective before the noun, you gotta use buen, the extra little word, buen. Él es un buen hombre. So, buen and bueno is the same. It's just a matter of where you want to put it. Before the noun, buen. After the noun, bueno. Él es un hombre bueno. Él es un buen hombre. Tengo un carro bueno. Tengo un buen carro. Alright? Now, let me teach you some extra things about these little words, bien, bueno, and buena. You might know that muy is used to emphasize something. La casa es muy grande. The house is very big. But I could also say, la casa es bien grande. So here we are using the word bien to emphasize the adjective, grande. La casa es bien grande. El carro es pequeño. El carro es muy pequeño. El carro es bien pequeño. La comida está buena. La comida está muy buena. La comida está bien buena. Está para chuparse los dedos. So you could use bien either for singular, masculine, feminine, or plural. I could say, estos pantalones son pequeños. Estos pantalones son muy pequeños. Estos pantalones son bien pequeños. So here we're not using bien to describe an action, to describe a verb, but to emphasize the adjective. La casa es grande. La casa es bien grande. The final thing I want to teach you today is about bueno and buena. Let's say you ask me, ¿cómo está él? I should say, él está bien. But if I say, él está bueno, I'm saying his body is attractive. Alright? If I say, ella está buena, instead of ella está bien, I'm saying her body is attractive. She's sexy. So just saying, be careful here. And bueno, it's also used as a filler word. I could say, bueno, déjame contarte. Well, let me tell you. Bueno, me voy a dormir. Well, I'm going to bed. Okay? So as a filler word, only the masculine version of it. Bueno. Bueno, that's it for today. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to subscribe and to give me a thumbs up. Thanks for learning with me. I highly appreciate it. And I'll see you next time in the next video. Ciao!